I think this time I really waited too long to review a product because this doesn't seem to be even available everywhere anymore. Especially in Germany, I can't find it anymore being sold. In the US, at least on Amazon, I found it for like 40, 45 bucks or so. And now the question comes up, why did I wait so long? I mean, when I got it a couple of months ago already and tried it, I actually liked it quite a lot. But after a few hours of listening, well, the nitpicker in me kicked in and I desperately started to look for flaws, and I maybe even found some, not that I can remember them by now, especially since I have been also reviewing the X sound here, and then for comparison sakes, recently I tried these again, and I noticed, just in comparison with those that cost about the same, of how much better these sound, and of actually once again getting reminded of how good these sound. So therefore I'm gonna keep this review a little bit shorter, so let's just get into the design. They maybe don't look that elegant. I think something like the X sound look way nicer, especially for example on the head. If I take this, this looks a little bit bulky, not really all that aesthetically pleasing anymore, like for example these. But I also have to say that the cutouts here are super nice, deep, big. My ear had no issues, of course, especially how hot it is here right now. It will pack up some heat after a while, but it was fine. We can also fold them up. Build quality feels fine for this price, absolutely. We get proper buttons, which I like for volume. If you long press them, it's for switching the tracks. Then we get a power button. We get, obviously, the port. Yeah, of course, this will be mic USB. Then the 3.5 millimeter jack, we have enough wiggle room and we can change that, and actually it's stiff enough, I would say, so I like that. But once I put them in, I actually just remembered how comfortable these are. Okay, they maybe don't look that great, but they have a very secure feel because they pretty much are lightweight. The clamping force is fine, they are thick and plush enough to get you covered, so they feel very, very comfortable for a longer period of time. The isolation, I would say, is also good because I hear myself muffled, but in a natural way, but it blocks out the biggest part of the noise. So in that regard, I'm pleased. Also very pleased when it comes to the controls, like I said, with the proper buttons, but also the volume. These have so much reserves. Actually, I listen crazy loud, and these, yeah, can get to a level where I have pain in my ears. So nice, I like that. Maybe not so much the only support of being SBC for the codecs, but when I actually tried it, the thing is, I think actually SBC sometimes gets a bad reputation because I had no issues with delay. But generally, what I've also seen on SBC headphones is that after a while, if you watch a video longer or if you skip ahead, it can get out of sync. But in normal testing, especially shorter videos, I actually had no issues. Also, the connection was stable, background noise, nope, and well, the microphone. Surprisingly clean. I mean, there was a little bit of some background hiss if you don't talk, but once you're talking, you don't hear it anymore. And then it was surprisingly good. Now, let's get to the sound. I'm gonna keep this quick. I'm gonna just rattle this off. Slightly wider, but actually for this price, surprisingly well built with the imaging actually giving you a fine structure. So, wow, I did not expect that. Then the vocals are slightly pushed forward, also kind of accentuated outside, so a little bit isolated, so you can focus on that, but it's not like they are the main focus, so I like that. Dynamic is good in terms of sound signature, a full warm bass, but actually a ton of treble, but not in a super harsh way. A little bit sibilant, yes, but actually very pleasing, and therefore this headphone at this price point feels incredibly kind of lightweight, open and airy, which I did not expect. Obviously, there are, since, like I said, a little bit more sibilant, not maybe that great for long-term use, but if you don't listen too loud, that shouldn't be an issue. Bass. Sub-bass was absolutely fine, but the presence was also good. It was very nice. It was quite strong, but definitely not kind of overemphasized. It did a good job, but it's definitely obvious that they pushed it a little bit, but on a really nice way, and the punch was also quite good, with a little bit of rumbling going on. Vocals, full and warm, but especially for this price point, I was surprised by the clarity that I simply did not expect at all. Then towards the highs, they go up very high, and there is a very smooth roll-off, which makes them almost feel a little bit sibilant, like I said, but I like that, because with that going to the absolute maximum before it gets maybe painful for some people, it also offers a little bit more of a refreshed look. They feel lighter, not heavy in terms of bass or the mids kind of being recessed too much, but they lift up the whole thing. Everything sounds nice and pleasing. We get a nice amount of detail, so I like that. They work for all music very well. So let's get to the pros and cons already. Very good comfort and fit. Good price at around $40 wherever you can find them still. And for this price, actually an almost unbelievably, almost kind of ridiculously good sound, especially the sound signature is very pleasing. Maybe for some people who are looking for something very mainstreamy with a lot of bass, not that much, it could already be a little bit on the fatiguing side, but yeah, that's actually, I think, the next step over mainstream sound, because you should be into a little bit more highs, especially if you get older and don't hear them so much anymore, even though I still do. And they are very, very loud. On the con side, well, only SBC, which for this price point I don't think is an issue. And maybe, like I said, the slightly little, yeah, focus on the highs. Competition, well, the only ones that I have here are the X Sound 3 that look nicer and at first moment feel a little bit more comfortable, but they get a little bit warmer earlier. But in terms of sound, nowhere near, way more muddy, just not as clear and so on. So I'm going to keep this quick. I like these a lot. If you can still get them and you don't want to spend more than like $40-$50, these are a total recommendation. And once again, I don't know why I've waited so long, because back then I said, yeah, maybe they are a little bit shouty or maybe great in for this price, complaining about that, which I can't even hear right now if I just listen to them normal casually. No way. These are legit. And period. Bye.